311, Charles Avenue.
Okay, the first thing there on 18-4128 Street, I have a report. Served up mail is sent to the address, which is the address that we're on right now. The mail is returned forward. The notice is on the subject property and we have the city hall. I have photographs that were taken today that shows the subject property on the 8th Street. And that day, from the building official, they're saying that those photos were taken today and those are part of our law. If I should have motions to spread all that.
So, exactly. All in favor?
Aye.
Those who are here. Does anyone in the audience, owner of properties at 18-441 28th Street? 18-441.
It's David or Lisa Waits.
David or Lisa Waits, do you know the apartment? Sure, sorry, sure. President?
Second.
Go ahead, second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Those who are here.
Okay, I have a resolution prepared to adjudicate the property, which is the recognition of the building official, which is not, has been done, changed from the first of the property. If you have the motion to adjudicate.
Second.
All in favor, roll call, Parker.
Aye.
Conchetti.
Aye.
Stephen.
Aye.
Ms. Henderson.
Aye.
Carula.
Aye.
Ms. Lloyd.
Aye.
Mr. Penn.
Aye.
Okay, on the second property, there's Carula, Charles Avenue, owned by Clinton McDonald. A certified letter was sent to the address as appears on the tax rolls, the same as returned forward. The notice was posted at city hall and on the subject property. I have photographs that were taken today showing the subject property, which the building official has said that they brought their, the property into compliance with city ordinances. I have an affidavit stating that the photos taken today and those who are proposed will get a motion to spread.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Is Mr. McDonald present?
Mr. McDonald, owner of property, here's Charles Avenue, present?
Okay, just need a motion to close the hearing, that's the first.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Those who are here.
We just had a motion, the mayor, that says the property is at this time in compliance with city ordinances.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Those who are here. Okay, next we'll start our regular scheduled meeting for May 3rd, 2011. If you would join Alderman Parker, invitation and plea.
Your kind Father, thank you for this beautiful day and thank you for the opportunity to serve the people of Long Beach. We come here with wisdom that we do what's right for the city, all the people within the city and the taxpayers. We ask you to give us that wisdom, that we make that right decision. And we thank you for the blessings you bless us with today and the blessings yet to come, for we ask in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen.
Amen.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Senator Moore, Mr. Parker, present. Mr. Conchetti, here. Mr. Stephen.
Present.
Ms. Henderson.
Here.
Mr. Carula.
Here.
Mr. Lysham.
Here.
Mr. Hammond.
We are.
City Clerk Rebecca Schroeck on my left. Our police chief McDowell, Wayne McDowell, Board Commission Chairman Keys, Fire Chief George Bass, City Engineer David Paul, and also tonight we have a representative from Secretary of State's office, Mr. Ray Carr, back to back. Pleased to have everyone here. take the time out of your night to be with us. Let's see, bids?
Okay, we just need motion on the slide to serve the fruit publication.
So, sir.
I'm hoping you don't want to.
Y'all will do that?
No, no, sir. Advertise for that, and ask it to try it.
Motion.
Okay.
Discussion.
Discussion.
Oh, we just.
We're doing that second for him.
Yes, did we change the scope of work, because we chose to redid this one, the price came into mind, we had all the changes.
Yeah, they changed some of our scope of work originally from the original. And it saved it very hard. Oh, this is the second meeting, this is the second planning.
It's okay.
So we're just hoping the bids are cheaper this time?
Well, yeah, we were within, the real low bidder was within our original estimate, and he failed to fill out some forms, and so we had to reject the bids.
And so that's been 6 months ago, we've been doing this all over again.
Okay.
All right, we have a motion, second, any other discussion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. We need to advertise final road bridge replacement.
So.
All in favor? Discussion, go ahead.
I just want to know, Mr. Ball, what is the timeframe for that construction?
It's a 90 calendar day project. If we get a good bridge contractor, they'll be able to knock out a little quicker from that, though. I don't think we're going to run this.
Which is a lot quicker than the other road.
Well, Mark, we had a class in bridge building at 101 Bridge Road, and we graduated that, so.
The contract does all 9 days, and then they can, it's like, I'm good for you.
Okay.
I see a little advertising, a letter, and some here. Is it also on data tags?
We put it in the, I'm not sure about data tags, but we do put it in the Mississippi Purchasing House, or whatever that's called. There is another place that we have to put it by law, and we put it in there.
Procurement Center.
Yes, ma'am, I'm sorry. But I'm not sure about data tags, but we do get contractors that see it on data tags to call, so I'm not sure exactly how it gets on there.
Okay.
A motion, second, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Announcements, presentation, and proclamation. Have a proclamation.
Mr. Mayor, while you were with the, I just want to say that I'm going to have to leave early tonight. I have a lot of this being confirmed, and I'll leave early.
So we give it to us. We're going to be out here by 6. Okay, do we have anyone from Goodwill?
Yes, sir.
Goodwill Industries enhances the quality and dignity of life for individuals, families, and communities on a global basis through the power of work by eliminating barriers to opportunity for people with special needs and by facilitating empowering self-help and service through dedicated autonomous local organizations. And whereas the vision statement of Goodwill Industries International is Goodwill Industries will be satisfied only when every person in the global community has the opportunity to achieve his or her fullest potential as an individual and to participate and contribute fully in all aspects of a productive life. Now, therefore, I, William Skelly, Jr., Mayor of the City of Long Beach, Mississippi, hereby proclaim the week of May 1st and ending May 7th, 2011, as Goodwill Industries International Week in the City of Long Beach.
Thank you, Chief.
Sir, job. Members of this board.
I have a couple of invoices that should come to mind that came in late, that we need to take a week off of funds.
So, they all play on the day, I motion carries. All right, public comments, 10 minutes total, annual agenda items only. We have Tom Stokes, representing, I guess, court commission.
That's incorrect.
You're talking about court commission minutes?
Yes.
Okay.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor, for all of my Tom Stokes, Commodore, 2011, Long Beach Yacht Club. This is your community-based yacht club. The Long Beach Yacht Club is requesting the table of the April 26th harbor commission minutes for 30 days. This should be of the Long Beach Yacht Club sufficient time to contact the Secretary of State to resolve the omission of private club status missing in the harbor commission minutes. Long Beach Yacht Club is a 501(c) nonprofit corporation. We are the community-based access to sailing for all ages, which includes Long Beach High School Sailing Team, United States Sailing National Regattas, International Sailing Events, and Olympic Selection Regattas. Long Beach Yacht Club participates in your local tourism activities, such as cruising the coast, Mardi Gras Chamber of Commerce culinary events, the Junior Fishing Rodeo, the Mississippi Deep Sea Fishing Rodeo, high school boys and scout boater education classes, and many, many school and local social functions. All of these yacht club opportunities are for the Long Beach community's benefit, at no cost to the taxpayers of the city of Long Beach, Mississippi. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's see, John Dawson.
Mayor, members of the board, good afternoon. I'm John Dawson, Associate Counsel, retained by Long Beach Yacht Club, addressing you today. We're here in connection with two things. One is the existing lease that's been in place with City of Long Beach since 1983, and also the proposed lease between the City of Long Beach, the Court Commission, and the Secretary of State's office. Having reviewed that, let me say this. It's quite obvious that no assignment to a private nonprofit club would be permitted. It must serve the public. It cannot just be beneficial to the public. It must be certain. If approved, the Long Beach Yacht Club will not be permitted to operate as a private club at the current location. And in essence, that lease would shut down, close the door. What we are requesting is a 30-day tabling to give us time to work with the City of Long Beach, the Port Harbor Commission, and the Secretary of State's office to resolve this issue so the Long Beach Yacht Club can continue to operate at its current location. It's our position, Long Beach Yacht Club serves a higher public interest than just being a private club, and is not injurious to the tidelands at a particular site, and should therefore be an exception under the lease now in consideration.
Well, sir, it is an exception. There's nothing changed, it's grandfathered, it's there. And I was on the phone with Secretary Hogan this afternoon, and we discussed these issues, and he said that it's grandfathered, and we kind of excluded it as far as singling out, you know, it to be a separate lease with him or anything. He said it would be still on the court commission and grandfathered.
We would think that it should be that, but it does not say that in the lease.
Well,
paragraph 6.
I think it.
Paragraph